Welcome to the Arkansas Weather Blog. We are your ticket to big weather events. Boy, what I would do for scenes like what you just saw there with snow so I could break out the snow skis and go skiing. This winter is just, for snow lovers, it's just horrible. There's no other way of putting it. Anyway, a couple of things I want to get into. The topic of this blog post will be about the active weather pattern as we head through the weekend and into next week. And I'm saying active in terms of temperature swings and precipitation chances, not anything wintry whatsoever. What a day Friday. I'm now sitting at 51 degrees in West Little Rock at 3:30 in the afternoon on Friday. It's been a struggle to get out of the 40s. We've got this boundary slicing through central Arkansas, and the temperature difference on either side of the front is just enormous, where you've got 30s and 40s across northern Arkansas and the 60s and 70s across the south. I have seen more extreme temperature differences across Arkansas, but this one is very significant. It's tough to forecast in these situations, too, but the temperature is going to continue to rise slowly before falling again behind a frontal boundary. I'll go through that again with the topic of this blog discussion in just a second. But before I do that, I want to remind you, everybody who entered the winter weather contest here on the Arkansas Weather Blog, we have our own page tracking that. You just click on Winter Contest in the navigation bar, and you'll see how you're doing or how everybody else is doing. I just updated that today, and now as we get into the end of January, February, get down to the nitty-gritty, I'll be updating that every day. So good luck on that. Great prizes we're giving away. Also, on my Facebook fan page, and this only goes through 9 a.m. Saturday, the 21st, voting, go to my Facebook page. Like it. I'd like you to do that, please. And what I did is I put a call out for snow dances for all the snow lovers out there. I got quite a response of videos of people doing snow dances, their own version of snow dances. I picked the top three, put them on my Facebook page, and now you can vote by liking which one is the best, and you'll see three of them. Now, I've posted four. There's one that's more of a demonstration. It's hilarious. I wanted to post it from Carson Griffin, I believe is the boy's name. I wanted to post that on there just so everybody can see it, but it's not in the contest. You'll see the three that are, so check that out. Now let's get into the model data with this very active weather pattern we're going to be dealing with over the next week or so. This is the early morning run of the GFS for Friday, and let me just give you briefly what we're looking at here. I know it looks great to you, all these lines and such, but we're looking at 2 meter temperatures. You see this blue line right here? So this is just off the ground. You see this line says zero, and it's going through Oklahoma and through Missouri. Well, that's 0 degrees Celsius, so that's 32 degrees Fahrenheit. So there's your freezing line right there at 2 meters, just off the ground. The black lines are isobars, lines of equal barometric pressure. You know, we talk about high pressure, we talk about low pressure. Well, you see right here, there's a frontal boundary. There's the structure of the front. And it's right here. You can see little areas of low pressure right along the frontal boundary. This is at midnight tonight, on Friday night and Saturday morning. So the frontal boundary is getting a move towards the east, and we're starting to get some cold air advection across portions of Arkansas as high pressure comes in out of northern portions of Iowa. So high pressure is nosing in. The frontal boundary here is starting to push on off towards the east. And we're getting cool later on tonight. Now, I'm just going to take you through this. The front moves off towards the east. This is Saturday at noon. All the green here is showing you what precipitation over the past 3 hours. So very, very light stuff, but you see most of the precipitation is located right in here with the frontal boundary well east of Arkansas now. This area of high pressure here keeps us dry and cool on Saturday, but the thing is it quickly moves off towards the east, and it sets up the return flow on Sunday, and you can already see that happening across the southern and central plains. Look at these black lines, the isobars, tightly packed up, and you can see that there's very windy conditions across the plains ahead of the next storm system. So as this high moves away, watch what happens. Let's go into Sunday here. Let's go to Sunday at noon. Okay, Sunday at 3 o'clock. The new front is coming closer to Arkansas, and you can see these southwesterly winds developing across Arkansas, so it's much warmer. This is the 10 degrees Celsius line up here through Missouri, 20 degrees Celsius, so you can see that it's pushing all that colder. The freezing line is well towards the north, frontal boundary taking shape, and you're getting, there's just not a lot of time here between storm systems for the instability to gather. And most of the instability is going to be located south and east of Arkansas. But as this frontal boundary comes in, I think that we're going to see some rain and some thunderstorms late Sunday. Let's take you in. There we go. This is Sunday at 9 p.m. I think you're going to see some thunderstorms across maybe central, but more likely into southeastern and east central Arkansas late Sunday into the very early morning hours on Monday. So this is Monday morning. Let me get here. Monday morning at 6 a.m. Low pressure located across the lakes. This is the frontal boundary. This is according to one model of the GFS. So the front is passes again, and a new area of high pressure is coming in, bringing in a northwesterly wind flow across Arkansas. So we warm up Sunday, and then we cool back down coming up on Monday morning. There's the 32-degree line at the surface, or at 2 meters, I should say. So the freezing line is not quite in Arkansas, but you can see it is getting cooler after a mild day on Sunday and a windy one at that. So now let's go to our next weather maker. You can see the high pressure settling on top of us on Monday. And here we go. Tuesday at 6 a.m., a new area of low pressure, which is coming out of the southwestern United States, will be coming at us from the south and west. You can see warm air coming up from the Gulf of Mexico and moisture as well. And this area of low pressure seems to want to close itself off and kind of meander around. I know I'm kind of going fast through this, but I'll go into Wednesday morning. Okay, this is Wednesday at 6 a.m. You see low pressure forming well towards the south here. Actually, it's near Brownsville, Texas. Here's the freezing line, and here's the 50-degree line. Yeah, that's about 50 degrees Fahrenheit at 2 meters. So you're getting rain coming in, and it's a chilly rain at that. There's an area of low pressure aloft helping generate all this precipitation. Next Wednesday, you're getting a northeasterly wind flow, an east-northeasterly wind flow at the surface. So this is a cold, gloomy rain coming in by the middle portion of next week. All right, let's go into late Wednesday. This is late Wednesday. And you can see the rain continues across portions of Arkansas. So this one would be a chilly rain, maybe a rumble of thunder, but probably nothing severe whatsoever. So we're talking about a very active weather pattern, but still nothing that really brings us any wintry weather. I do think, as I said earlier, I do think things will change into February, and that'll be our best chance. Obviously, it's our only chance at seeing any wintry weather. I'll keep you updated on Facebook. Todd Jacoby, and look me up on Twitter as well, KATV_weather. And of course, it's always here, in-depth weather, only on the Arkansas Weather Blog here at KATV.com. We are your ticket to big weather events.